We've just made the discovery that arsenic, which is present in the Earth's crust, can cause a very, very common liver disease called fatty liver disease. Fatty liver disease is really in the spotlight because it's associated with obesity and type 2 diabetes. And a lot of the emphasis on fatty liver disease has been about nutrition and lifestyles. But I think the missing piece there, which I'm very excited about from our research, is that along with high fat, high sugar diets, and low activity, we're all exposed to compounds in the environment. Most of us don't even know what those compounds are. And in our study, we found that just arsenic alone in zebrafish is capable of causing fatty liver disease with a very, very high incidence. So our experiments where we simply add arsenic to the water, almost all the fish end up getting fatty liver disease after 4 or 5 days of exposure. A lot of the toxicants that we all are exposed to are not from any human activity at all. They're just part of the bedrock. So arsenic, lead, mercury, nickel, all of these are metals that are found in the bedrock. Most of us are exposed to them. If we are exposed, it's through the drinking water, because the drinking water comes out of the earth, and whether you get it in a plastic bottle or out of a well, it originated in the earth. Where it becomes a problem is where we don't filter them out. We are all exposed to many, many factors in our environment. We're also endowed with a genetic legacy of what we're predisposed to develop as far as a disease or be resistant. So that's nothing to be afraid of. It happens to all of us, and we all have been managing for millennia. But what our study showed was that giving a very low level of arsenic on its own doesn't seem to do anything that we could detect. Giving a low dose of alcohol also doesn't seem to do anything that we could detect. The fish appear completely normal, but when you put those two low doses together, boom, they get a very severe liver disease. So this speaks to the fact that there's a synergy between different exposures that can promote a disease. And so what our hypothesis is that maybe this big explosion of diabetes, fatty liver disease, could be linked to an environmental stressor, but also needs to be compounded with the nutrition and activity aspect. So it may be that we're focusing on only one part of the picture by looking at nutrition and activity in this disease.